Process. Already last class you have studied gravity, die casting, and
hot chamber die casting process and cold chamber die casting process. So in this session, so we have to concentrate about the next process. It is called as a squeeze casting process. So squeeze casting process, another name it is called as a squeeze forming process or liquid forming process. Liquid forming process, squeeze casting or squeeze forming or liquid metal forming process. So in this squeeze casting process, it is a combination of casting and forging process. It is a combination of squeeze casting in this process, combination of casting as well as forging. Okay, so in this process, the mainly we can see this figure clearly. Casting and forging operation both simultaneously can act on that liquid metal. So here you can see this figure clearly, understand. So this one is a ram moving at forward and backward direction, upward and downward direction. So the ram is moving with the help of hydraulic press. This is example for you can take the hydraulic press. So this one is a mold. This one is a mold. We can pour the motor metal here. First step, you can see there the sequence of casting operations. The first one you can see, pour motor metal into the mold. So you can put it here. Second one is a squeeze metal in the mold and maintain pressure. So the ram is hydraulic press is moving forward upward and downward direction with the help of this ram. And after that, once we can impact on this pressure on this liquid metal, after that the ram is moving at upward direction, eject and finish the casting, and the process is complete. Here we can see the first step, before that we have to put a molten metal, after that the ram is moving at downward direction, impact on that, so it is called as a forming process, sorry, forging process. Due to the pressure, the shape of that one, according to the die, you can take the shape of that die of the liquid metal. After solidified, the moving ram at upward direction and taken from the component from this die. So next you can go for this one. You can see the other figure, squeeze casting process. So this is a bottom die. This is a hatching line. It shows the bottom die. So this one is a ejector pin is there. So next is a top die. Top die is moving, this top die will be attached to the hydraulic press, the moving upward and downward direction. The top die is moving with the help of upward and downward direction with the help of hydraulic press. So you can hear the bottom die, you can put a liquid metal here. Liquid metal. Once the hydraulic press will be moving at downward direction, this upper top of the die is moving at downward direction. The impact on this liquid metal, so you can take the shape of this one. Actually, this is a component. This one is a required component. One after solidified, after solidification, so we can taken from this component with the help of this ejector pin. Ejector pin is provided at the bottom side of this one. So this is a squeeze the metal. Second step is very important. The force is applied in this liquid metal, the squeezed metal. That's why it is called as a squeezed. This one squeezed casting or squeezed forming or squeezed liquid forming method. That's why they're same method. So the first step, so this second step, this one is a third important step. This is actually component. And next to go for this one, steps involved in this process. So the first important step is the process makes a use of two dies. So two dies means one is a bottom die, another one is a top die. Bottom die is a fixed or stationary, and top die is moving upward and downward direction with the help of hydraulic press. Second important point, the bottom die is preheated. Before using that, you have to preheat it.
So nearly about 200 to 250 degree centigrade. The bottom die will be before using that. So preheated. So temperature nearly about 200 to 250 degree centigrade with the help of a torch or sprayed coated by water based graphite and lubricants also you can use. After heating, so you can spray with lubricants based on water graphite lubricants. Fire clay or facilitate easy to remove of the casting after solidification. Why it is lubricant is necessary, why it is needed. So after solidified, after solidification, after easy to remove purpose, removal purpose, the lubrication is very essential. So that's why first is to make a two dies, bottom and top die. Second point is preheated nearly about 200 to 250 centigrade. After that, and sprayed with a lubricant. So why it is lubricant is needed, necessary to easy to remove the component. That's why lubrication is lubricants or can use that. And third step, go for the third important step for this process. So major quantity of molten metal is poured into the bottom dies. It is very important. So major quantity, how much quantity is depending on the shape of the component. Depending on the shape of the component, you have to measure approximately and put into the bottom die. So as shown in figure first step. So next fourth point, top die is moving downwards rapidly towards the bottom die. To apply the pressure, the top die moving at downward direction and apply the pressure on the molten metal. This causes the molten metal gets squeezed. This causes, once you can, the upper die will be impact on that liquid metal. This causes molten metal get squeezed and fill the mold die cavity. It is very simple mechanism. So once you can drop die moving at downward direction, impact on that liquid metal. So this causes the molten metal gets squeezed and fill the mold cavity or die cavity is completely liquid metal is filled due to the pressure of this top die. So next point, so we can go for the fifth one. The metal is held under pressure until it is solidifies. Up to solidification, the pressure will be impact on that liquid metal. After solidified, to remove the top die and we'll get the final product or component. After solidification, the top die is removed. After the solidification, you can wait, depending on that material, you can wait 2 hours or 1 hour at room temperature. You can solidification taking place. After that, the top die is removed with the help of ejector pin. So casting component is taken from the bottom die. So as shown in figure third one, first figure, second figure, three figures you have seen. The first figure, the process makes a two dies. One is a bottom die and other one is a top die. The bottom die is a preheated before using that. So nearly about 200 to 250 centigrade with the help of torch or and sprayed lubricants, easy removal purpose, and major quantity of molten metal you can put into the bottom die. And top die moved downwards, moving at downward direction and impact on that liquid metal. This causes the molten metal get squeezed and fill the cavity or die cavity. After that, the metal is held under pressure until it solidifies. This is very important. Metal is held under pressure until it solidifies. After solidification, the top die is removed with the help of ejector pin. The cast or component is taken from the bottom die as shown in figure C. So next step is advantages of this process, squeeze casting. So the main advantage of this squeeze casting, intricate shape can be easily, complicated or irregular shape can be easily casted or easily produced. Intricate shape means it is a complicated or irregular shape. So this is a intricate shapes can be easily produced using up because of very high pressure squeeze the molten metal easy to enter the cavity. That's why they easy to reach the cavity, completely fill that. That is a misrun. It is not happens in this because of the high pressure will impact on the liquid metal. So metal is squeezed and easy to flow the very thin section or complicated shape or irregular shape. Easy to metal is flowing and completely fill the cavity. So that's why this squeeze casting is very important role. Intricate shape can be easy to produce. Second advantage of this process, shrinkage and porosity is eliminated. Shrinkage and eliminated, it is porosity. Porosity is defects of the casting. So shrinkage and porosity is eliminated because of before entering to the cavity, very high pressure and squeezed liquid metal enter to the cavity. That is why shrinkage analysis is not a problem in this process, and porosity is also not defective in this process. Shrinkage and porosity is completely eliminated in this process because of pressure, due to the high pressure enter to the liquid metal to the cavity, and porosity and shrinkage is completely eliminated in this squeeze casting process. And third one is a very high pressure impact on that liquid metal, the good surface finish can be achieved. Good surface finish can be maintained or good surface can be obtained. So fourth one is a machining cost is reduced. Once you can good surface finish can be achieved, so machining cost is also reduced in this process, squeeze casting, because of there is a surface already, the good surface finish is obtained or achieved. So naturally the machining cost is reduced. So next one is very fine grain structure can be easily obtained. Because of liquid metal, once the pressure will be impact on that liquid metal and squeeze, and grain refinement or grain structure can be easily obtained. You can easy to obtain the grains uniformly distributed. Grain structure can be easily obtained means uniformly grains will be distributed of the component. Grain structure, very fine grain structure can be easily obtained. Because of there is a squeezing of the liquid metal and pressure, that reason the grain structure can be easily obtained in this process. And drawbacks or limitation of this process, heavy casting cannot to be produced in this process. Heavy only, this is suitable for small, medium, but heavy casting it is not produced in this process using of the squeeze casting process. And the process is costlier as compared to other processes, it is a costly. And exact metering of the molten metal is very important, and not suitable for small quantity production. Number of pieces or number of components be required more, the one or two pieces is costly. So number of not suitable for small quantity, 500 or 100 is not suitable. Number of component will be maximum 1 lakh or 50 lakhs if they go for this process. So these are the main drawbacks for squeeze casting process. So next process, it is go for the Tixo casting process. Tixo casting process. Tixo casting is modified squeeze casting process. There is a major difference between some modification. Already we have studied squeeze casting process. Some modification, it is called as Tixo casting process. So what is the modification? You can see that the first point here, semi-solid molten metal is subjected to compressive force inside a die. Metal is shaped as desired required. So metal is a semi-solid condition, exhibits or Tixo triple behaves, that is velocity is reduced when the squeezed under the pressure. So you can see this very clearly. So this one is a top die. So this is a bottom die. So these are the ejector pins, there are two. So this is actually component, this one. Pressure is applying the top die is moving at downward direction to apply and squeeze the liquid metal, we'll get the shape of this. This shape will take place. After solidifying, to remove that top die, so with the help of ejector pin, we can take it from the component with the help of ejector pin. This is the third step. Some modification of this one. Squeeze casting process. So next step, you can go for this steps. What are the steps? Clearly understand what is the difference between what modified in this process. So the cavity mold is prepared according to the shape of the desired product. As per drawing, you can prepare the cavity mold. Okay, so as per the drawing given, as per dimensions. And semi-solid metals injected into the cavity. Semi-solid metals injected to the cavity. It is very important. Semi-solid metal is injected into the cavity. It is very important. Third one, top die move downward rapidly towards the bottom die to apply the pressure on the semi-solid metal. It gets squeezed. This causes the semi-solid metal cools and faster rate
and gets solidified. Clear, no? Stop die moving at downwards rapidly towards the bottom die to apply the pressure on the semi-solid metal. Okay, it gets squeezed. This causes, once you can the liquid metal squeezed, this causes the semi-solid metal cools at a faster rate. This is a and get solidified. And after solidification, component is taken out with the help of ejector pin. The once we can solidification taking completing, so component is taken from the cavity with the help of ejector pin. The dies used in this purpose are capable of withstanding wear and tear and high temperature. It is very important. So the dies used in this purpose, they're capable of withstanding the wear and tear and high temperature withstanding. It is a very important role. So this is a important note on that important point. So next we can go for the third one, is a slush casting, third process. Slush casting is a process in which a hollow casting are produced without use of coarse. So in sand molding, in first module you have studied, the coarse is used. Suppose hollow or cavity is required in that component, so coarse are used. But in slush casting, there is not necessary for using the coarse, then you can get the hollow shape. So slush casting is a process in which the hollow casting are produced without use of coarse. So how it is produced, this hollow shape? So you can go for the one by one. We can see here. This is the first figure. It shows that the molten metal we can put it. There is not necessary for the core. This is the surrounding of this sand. This is a shape of this component. I can put into the liquid metal here. So completely peel it, and after removing this one, the get the component finally without using of the core. The main point is without use of the core, we'll get the cavity or hollow in the component. So the process is not prepared to produce the object of engineering use. It is very important. This process is not prepared to produce the objective of engineering application. Instead of it is used to make an object like toys, lamps, base and other simple in the commercial purpose you can use it. But the engineering application is not suitable for this slush casting process. This process is not prepared to produce objective of engineering use. So instead it is used to make a object like statues, toys, lamps, base and other, where only the external features of the object are important. This process. So next we can go for the steps involved in this process one by one. So molten metal is poured into the metal mold with the permitted to solidify up to the required thickness. It is very important. Molten metal is poured into the metal mold and permitted to solidify up to the required thickness, 2 mm or 3 mm and few seconds. After that you can remove that liquid metal, you can remove that. So molten metal is poured into the metal mold and permitted to solidify up to required thickness for few seconds. This is a very important point. Some few seconds you have to wait, and after that some thickness is 2 mm or 3 mm or 4, depending on that requirement or drawing. So you can wait and remove the liquid metal inside that flask. This one, steps involved in the process. So molten metal is poured into the metal mold and permitted to solidify up to the required thickness for few seconds. You can see here. So first you can put it here, liquid metal, and you can wait few seconds and required thickness. This thickness is 2 mm or 3 mm, whatever requirement is there. So you can approximately you can measure, and you can remaining liquid metal you can remove that. After that we'll get the component. You can see this is the first step. Second step is important. When a cell of desired thickness is formed, then mold is inverted and remaining molten metal is drained out into the container. Second step, remained drained out is container. You can remove that liquid metal whatever thickness is required, few seconds you can wait. After that, so you can remove that liquid metal. After solidified, you will get the component. You can separate it these two boxes. Third step is the thickness of the cell is obtained depends upon the time for which the metal is allowed to solidify in the metal mold and also thermal conductivity of the mold. Third step, this one. Third step is the thickness of the cell. This is the thickness of the cell. This one, dark line, it shows that thickness of the cell obtained depends upon the time and depends upon the time for which the metal is allowed to solidify. 2 minutes or 3 minutes, depending on few seconds, depending on the material solidification taking place. On that basis, you have to remove the, drain the liquid metal. So 2 mm, 3 mm, 4 mm, depending on the, as per the drawing. So next is metal molds is made to two hollows to facilitate easy removal of the casting. So advantages of this process: simple in operation, it gives a good surface finish, operation is very fast and economical, hollow shape can be easily produced without the use of core. Drawbacks for this process: inside shape is not uniform. Inside shape is not uniform because of few seconds you have to remove the liquid metal. Thickness is 2 mm or 3 mm, so it is very difficult to maintain that thickness and surface finish in this process. So wall thickness is not uniform, definitely. Only low melting point alloy with narrow freezing ranges can be used. Process is used for art and decorative work only. It is not engineering application. This process is used only for decorative works or art or toys or lamps. This process is suitable. It is not for engineering application or engineering use. That is a major drawbacks for this process. So next one is last one, continuous casting process. So the continuous casting process here. So continuous casting is a casting process in which the operation of pouring the solid and removal of the casting from the open mold are carried out continuously. It is a long pipe continuously and cut it required length. You can cut it here. So you can see this figure clearly understand. So there are clearly understand. So this continuously is coming from this solidified casting. So 20 feet or 30 feet, depending on that, you have to cut that one. This one is a cut the length. So here, this is the main important, the water circulating surrounding here and water spray here and roller is there. With the help of this roller is continuously moving the solidified roll here. So there are tundish and reservoir and cooling water supply. So here, this one is also cooling water supply. Clearly understand this figure. So in this method, molten metal is continuously poured into the mold at one end and solid metal is drawn from the other end. Liquid metal you can put it to the top side and solid metal you can draw at the other end. Metal is continuously cut into the desired length. So 20 feet or 30 feet, depending on that, whatever length is required, according to that you can cut continuously. It is a liquid converted into solid with the help of passing the liquid metal in this system arrangement. So you can go for. So here steps involved. First is the molten metal is prepared by conventional melting process and transferred into the ladle. First you can prepare the liquid metal in the furnace and transfer to the with the help of ladle. So molten metal is continuously supplied from the ladle to intermediate ladle called is a tundish. The technical term it is called as intermediate ladle. Directly you can put the liquid metal in the tundish. From the here it is continuously poured into the mold. That's why you can use the tundish at a controllable rate, keeping the level of the constant position. The main function of the tundish is controllable rate and keeping the level at the constant position. The liquid metal is supplied to the this one is a next reservoir. Second point, it will need to come in second point. So you can see this second point important. The mold is used to made a copper. The mold is used to made up of a copper or graphite and open at both ends. Water cooling arrangement is provided. So you can see that is exact heat from the molten metal. And third important step,
the operation before the causing process start. Bottom of the mold is covered by the dummy bar, the bottom end of the required length. So you can put a dummy bar is fixed here. So motor metal from Tandish enters to the mold. The motor metal, once first you can put into the Tandish and enter to the mold, and it falls on the bar. Then molten metal starts filling into the mold. The water is continuously extracting the heat from the molten metal. Surrounding of the this one, water tubes are provided. So the continuously heat extract from the molten metal will continuously heat extracting the heat from the molten metal, so that it solidifies before it leaves the mold. Last point, the solidifies metal is continuously extracted with the help of dummy bar and is made pass through the pinch roller. Small rollers are used to extract the solid part. Finally, the solid metals cut into the desired length with the help of torch or cutting or shearing. So advantages of this process: no wastage of this metal. There is no chance of metal wasting. Second one is a sprue, runner, risers and etc. not used, not necessary for runner, riser, sprue, vent hole, gutters. Directly you will get into the component. So process is automatic, able to produce a sound product. It is a good surface finish as well as dimensional accuracy. It is maintained in this process. High mechanical properties high, uniformly great structure is obtained. So next is a produce extreme good surface finish. Limitations of this process: not suitable for small quantity of production. Area will be required more. The floor space is required more in this system, in this process. And high capital investment is necessary to set up the process. Initial investment is more as compared to other process. Initial investment is more. And fourth one, drawbacks. Just a simple shape can be cached. It is not a complicated or irregular shape. It is not possible to cache. Only that is a round shape or hollow pipe easy to cache in this process. So next fifth one is continuous and capable cooling of mold is required. Centrifugal casting. Casting is a process in which the molten metal is poured and allowed to solidify in revolving mold. The centrifugal forces due to the revolving mold force the molten metal against the mold wall until it solidified. Next process, centrifugal casting. So it is a simple process. The material used in the preparing the mold may be cast iron, steel, graphite. So this process, the process is used to making the casting of the main concept is hollow cylindrical shape. Centrifugal casting, it is a the main purpose, it is used for hollow cylindrical shape component you can easy to produce in this centrifugal casting process. So the various centrifugal casting technique, there are three important types of centrifugal casting process. First one is a true centrifugal casting process. Second one is a semi-centrifugal casting process and a centrifuge casting process. Mainly there are three important centrifugal casting process: true centrifugal casting, semi-centrifugal casting and centrifuge casting process. The detailed study one by one, the true centrifugal casting process. So you can see this is a solidified metal. Inside that dark line it shows that solidified casting. So this is a rotating with the help of shaft is there. So this is metallic mold. This one is a metallic mold. So this is a metallic mold is rotating with the help of this shaft and pouring the liquid metal in this basin. And this is a end cover plate. This is a end cover plate, means this is the one end will be cover, other end will be closed. So in this case, so second one you can see this is a horizontally you can rotate it. So this figure, it shows that the container, this is a metallic mold container, is rotated in the vertical. You can see this is the difference between these two. This metallic mold rotating in a horizontal parallel to the ground. So this figure, it shows that the metallic mold rotating in a vertical fashion. We can put into the liquid metal and splashes and surrounding of this container. Idenu stop aadane matadu stop madla.